My name is Ellen Reddy. I'm the executive director for Nollie Jenkins Family Center in Durant, Mississippi. Holmes County has a population of a little less than 19,000, majority African American, rural, low income community. Probably 99% of our students receive free and reduced lunch. So those are some of the issues, really helping young people to understand the connection between what we call school push-out, those things that push out kids from the schoolhouse to the jailhouse. One of the primary issues we worked on is the elimination of corporal punishment. This school year, we were finally able to eliminate corporal punishment as a form of discipline. We're then offering to the community and to parents and to students alternatives to corporal punishment. For example, the reason that you're here this weekend. We are doing a healing rebirthing process, getting students to understand that they have control over their behaviors, getting them to understand that it's okay not to fight and it's okay to come to agreements. So I think if we think about the work that we're doing as preventative, making those things not happen, or when we know they're happening, really stop those things from happening. But we really have to give our communities, our students, our parents, and our young people the tools and skills to do those things. We make an investment in our young people. A lot of the young people you see running around here have been in the program in one way or another, even if they're just here as part of a gathering. And our young people experience so much pain and trauma in their lives. I really want to help them to find ways that they can heal themselves.
Well, the roses won't leave unless you speak up. Oh, sweet, I love that.
No.
That is beautiful.
So those are really the things that we're trying to do, really to give our young people the tools and skills that they can use to heal themselves. 1 in 3 young people do not have a caring adult in their lives. So if you want to make a change, all you got to do is care. When young people get in trouble, they need to know that they have a caring adults in their lives that they can turn to. We've been very successful to recruit young ladies and young people, girls, into our program who are really invested. They come with questions and they come with all these beautiful spirits. But it's also about gathering and fellowshipping together. We've eaten this weekend and we spent time together, and those things matter. It's really about going back and finding those things that made the community a peaceful community. If we do not continue to create the next generation of leaders, if we don't change the culture of what is, we continue to have the same thing.
And we've been doing community organizing so that youth, students in middle and high school, and also elementary, have a voice in their education and can feel like they have power to change policies or procedures or anything that they want to change inside of their schools.
So it's important because they need to understand how change happens. They need to understand an organizing strategy that you build the base. That one person can make a difference, but when you go up against a system, you're gonna need more than one person. And that we need to change systems. We really need to change systems. We talked about the school to prison pipeline and pushing kids from school to the jailhouse. That starts early on. And if they can understand that every time they get a discipline write-up, that school or that principal or counselor is building that basically a record that will follow them for the rest of their lives, then they will do something very different. They will change the course of action. Nollie's back in 2012 established our Scholars of Peace peer mediation that looked at developing peacekeepers, making our young people peacekeepers, taking them through a process of understanding what it means to be compassionate, what it means to be kind, what it means to, in some instances, turn the other cheek. So those are really the kinds of tools and skills we want to give our young people, because we believe that we can be peacekeepers and peacemakers. The black and brown community has a history of oppression and colonization. And so I think as a community, we really have to look at the decisions we make around our children, how we discipline our children. What are those rites of passages that grow out of our own community? What are the healthy ways that we want to be together as communities? If you've got one person that you see a need, go and meet that need, because that person will bring you to other people. Because children do not come out of closets, they come out of families. And so if you can connect with the child, one child, you're also connecting to that child's family. And then you're connecting to the extended family. And that's what we have here. I mean, you know, we're an extended family in many, many ways. Yeah.